If you're like most woodworkers, you've probably seen or even have a cheap dust collector like this one. I've had two for many years and they don't work that great. I've never really loved mine, and in an effort to maximize its suction, I've tried a lot of things, including removing the bag filter that I thought was pretty much useless, exhausting it directly outside because I love my neighbors, and I've even tried to add a cheap trash can cyclone separator to try to save on bags. Now this kinda worked until my shop grew, and most notably, until I got a table saw, which, as it turns out, are notoriously bad at dust collection. Unless you take advantage of 2 4-inch hose ports, which my Harbor Freight dust collector could not do. That sent me deep down the rabbit hole of dust collection, and boy, did I learn a ton. In a quest to find a system that would work for me, there are 3 things that I learned that surprised me, and I want to pass them on to you to help you save money and time and researching. I'll share with you the lessons I learned about cheap HEPA filters, cheap particle separators, and flex hose. I'll also show you what it was like installing my dream dust collection system and what it was like turning it on for the first time. Now you need to be aware that there are actual HEPA filters and fake HEPA filters. A lot of people advertise HEPA filter, but they don't give clear data on both the size, micron, it filters, and most importantly, what percentage of that is captured. Companies like to throw the buzzword HEPA around, but often fail to provide third-party data backing up their marketing claims. One thing that I like about Oneida is that they use actual HEPA media and have the data to back it up. Now, if you actually do get your hands on a quality HEPA filter, you're going to need to clean it eventually. And this is where a lot of people immediately waste their money without realizing it. HEPA media is very sensitive, and a lot of lower quality filters come with a cleaning paddle, and that seems like a convenient and good idea. I've seen people crank down on those like crazy to clean the dust off the HEPA filter. But if you do that, you run the risk of immediately destroying and compromising the delicate filters, which immediately compromises filtration efficiency and therefore immediately allows the concerning particulate that you bought the expensive filter for back into the air. It's very counterproductive, and a lot of people don't realize that they're ruining them. It's much better to use compressed air and take a touchless approach to cleaning your HEPA filter. You'll protect the HEPA media and you'll do a better job at cleaning it too. My first attempt at using a separator was basically useless. It kind of did the job, but because the separator wasn't separated from the dustbin, once the dustbin filled up to about 30%, the sawdust would get sucked up into my air filter. I bought a trash can separator to limit the amount of times that I'd have to change my bag. And what would happen instead is the bag would still fill up, but because I wasn't expecting it to or paying attention, it almost always overfilled the bag, creating a giant mess, which meant that I needed to stop what I was doing, put a mask on, get a vacuum, and all of that. Basically, when you're not realizing it, after you get to about 30% full of the trash can, the cyclone still goes, but then it just picks all that dust back up and puts it into the bag. You think you're separating, but you're not. You're building, you're having fun, and then within an hour, you're overflowing your dust collector. Trash can separators by design also severely restrict the airflow. By restricting airflow, you are getting significantly less collection at the tool where you need it the most. And so for this reason, it's important to have cyclone separators engineered for the least amount of pressure drop as possible. It's best to have your separating done by a cyclone, but be warned, not all cyclones are created equal. We're dealing with physics here, and it's really important that you size your cyclone to the motor. Now, there's a lot of complicated science here, and the good news is you don't need to learn it all. Let the experts at Oneida who do this every day help you size everything so that you get the most efficient setup possible. It's pretty easy for them to do it. I initially planned on mounting my 2-horsepower motor fan to the wall, and then I wanted to add a dust deputy cyclone and then hard pipe all of my tools. And that sounds like a good idea, and I thought I could save a bunch of money doing that. And that was until you run the CFM models on it and you start factoring in the unbelievable draw that ductwork has on your CFM. Now, once we ran the calculations, despite upgrading the impeller to my cheap Harbor Freight motor, our CFMs at the tool would have been right at the minimum CFM needed to start working, and it would not have been a good option or worth any of the time or money. I had 2 options: continue with my hacked Harbor Freight setup and take a single flex hose to each tool, which would have worked, or upgrade my motor and cyclone size so that I can put hard piping everywhere it needs to go to be as efficient as possible. Obviously, you can see which way I went. Now, there are a lot of companies and brands that sell dust collectors. And after researching a bunch of options and companies, I settled on Oneida because I wanted the best and I wanted to do this process once. Oneida does dust collection. It's their thing, that's their business. And when it comes to something like dust and my health, I wanted to trust a company whose sole focus and obsession and competency is dust collection, and not just a vendor who would sell me anything. I also really liked the people that I met there. I spent over a year getting to know the people there because this was a huge decision and I was secretly interviewing them without them knowing it. They were accessible, easy to talk to, and explained things when I had questions, and they didn't condescend down to me if I had what I felt like was a dumb question. I initially thought that I needed a supercell because I'd seen a lot of those on YouTube and they were clearly more powerful than what I had. But after consulting with Oneida and they learned what I really needed, we settled on the Dust Gorilla Pro. It would be more than enough than what I needed now, but would also serve me well in the future. I sent Oneida this sketch of how my shop is laid out, and a short time later, I got this PDF with the best way to lay out all the ductwork with the appropriate size dust collector for my needs. Oneida also has what they call Smart Boost, which monitors your system for suction loss and automatically adjusts the fan's motor speed to compensate. This is like really cool, and it's nice that no matter what's going on at the tool or the cutter head or what size port you have, you don't have to think about all this stuff. The motor can sense these things, make adjustments on the fly. It's pretty cool. Now, when the box arrived, I was honestly blown away by how well everything was packed. Every single part was secured, padded, and organized like it was built to survive the apocalypse. There was no rattling, no loose pieces, just a solid professional job. One thing that really stood out to me was how clearly everything was labeled. I didn't have to guess what part was what or go looking for a YouTube video to figure things out. Each piece was clearly marked and matched perfectly with the instructions, which made the whole setup process so much easier. And speaking of instructions, they were super straightforward. Pairing that with the organized packing made it a breeze to get this up running fast. Now, I bought a lot of tools and equipment over the last 20 years, and I can honestly say Oneida sets the bar of how products should be shipped and packed. It's obvious that they thought through every detail to make the customer experience top-notch and easy. So if you're on the fence about ordering one of these systems, let me tell you, not only is the product fantastic and works and keeps your shop clean, but the way they deliver it to your door makes the whole process completely stress-free. Now, the toughest part of the whole install process was lifting the heavy motor 8 feet in the air. I thought it would be comical to replace my Harbor Freight dust collector motor with the assist of a Harbor Freight electric hoist. It got us close, but our ceiling height was an issue, and I ended up needing to call a strong neighbor who came over and helped my dad and I put it into place. I thought I was recording the footage, but I can't find the video, which is good because it was really embarrassing. Be very careful here. This is the one place that you can really get hurt. The motor is heavy. The other challenge that I ran into was cutting the metal piping to the lengths that I needed. Now, after watching other people on YouTube, I found out that drilling in a hole and then cutting that with a jigsaw was really the easiest way to go about doing this. If you do this, just make sure you file the edges down. Now, I opted to go with NordFab adjustable ducts, partly for the ease of installation, but also because I'm moving shops in about 9 months and I didn't want to permanently install rigid ducts to only take them down and possibly cut them again in the new shop. If you've ever looked at dust collection, you've probably come across these NordFab ducts and they live up to the hype. They are amazing and in my estimation, some of the best piping on the market. They are well worth the investment. I was so excited to finally have my dream dust collection set up that I didn't think to ask for help ahead of time. I was by myself on the day that I wanted to install the ducts, and I was determined to get the ductwork in the air by myself. I made it work. It was awkward, kind of embarrassing, but I was able to do it by myself. I was nervous about installing all of this because I've never done anything like this before, but it didn't take me long to put things together, and I'm horrible at this type of stuff. Most of that was with a big help of Oneida and their instructions. Now here's me turning it on for the first time. It sounds like an airplane is taking off from the shop. Now, I currently have my planer, jointer, 2 4-inch ports on my table saw, and an auxiliary blast gate in the ceiling hooked up, and my shop has never been cleaner. Here's what it looks like cutting at the table saw without dust collection. Makes a ton of mess. Here's what it looks like with just the cabinet 4-inch port on. It's awful, and this is why I caught Oneida in the first place. Thankfully, you can get an overarm setup, but that means you have to run 2 4-inch ports at the same time, something that my Harbor Freight setup would not do. But with the Dust Gorilla Pro, it's flawless. Check this out, almost no sawdust when using both at the same time. I'm so glad that I have the world's best dust collection company on task in my shop. The Dust Gorilla Pro not only reduced sawdust in my shop, but it's also reduced the friction that I used to have in building things. Before, I would have to move a hose from my table saw to the planer and then to the joiner and then go back and forth. And if I was in the middle of milling something and had to go back and forth, it took so much time, so much effort, and I kind of just didn't want to do that. Now that everything is hard piped in, I can mill and do things on a table saw, joiner, and planer fast. If you're at a place where you need better dust collection, give Oneida a call and put them on your dream tool list like I did. The experts on staff have been great, and they are the right people to help you build out the solution you need. I'll have this set up in my shop for the next 40 years, and I'll probably hand it down to my kids. Thanks, Oneida.